Cassie, you've been strong pretty much all year, indoor and outdoor. Yeah. Has that? What did you do during the off season to get prepared for this whole year, spring season?
I'm just building a base with training and stuff, working on specific techniques, and you know, just really working on focusing on the big picture and not reading too small or too much into the little details.
Jake, you qualified for nationals late in the year. You had to go to Georgia Tech, kind of get extra jump in to get there. And kind of, was that maybe a little stressful for you trying to make it back?
No, I don't believe it was stressful. I just had to take it one step at a time, and I had to deal with an injury and just make sure that I got stronger and was able to stop that from happening again. So far, I've been healthy, and that hasn't lingered at all. But taking that step to jump and get a bar in, but even though it was an unattached meet, so it didn't really count for the NCAA, but it was a rust buster, and I kind of was able to start the season up well. I guess so. I didn't tear it or anything. It was just a pretty good strain. Just had to start over and rehab and strengthen that muscle up again. But it's doing well, and I haven't had any issues with it.
As your coaches, what makes a good pole vaulter? It seems like such a unique sport.
Absolutely.
Physically and mentally.
Yeah, I think it's a big deal mental, just because if you think about it, you're running down there and just putting a pole in a box and flying over a bar. You got to be definitely mentally strong and be competitive and not be and have any type of fear or anything like that. You just got to be very mentally strong, but you got to have the will to compete and win and be an athlete.
There's three field events represented for both men and women's side, being field athletes. What is there growth that needs to happen, or is it just youth and it'll come? And what would y'all like to see represented more?
As far as from when we get to the college level, or I think just a big maturity. You know, it's not like we're running around the track. If you mess up a little bit, it kind of throws off the whole throw or the whole jump. So you have to be pretty mentally tough. So just working on that mental strength is really important for a field event, especially, I think. You know, like I said, a sprinter, you know, you mess up the blocks, but you still have 100 meters to get down the track and hopefully make up for a little bit. But a throw or a throw lasts, you know, a split second, and a jump, if you overreach on a step or anything like that, you kind of have to adjust really quickly.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think maturity is a big factor in that, especially when you're young and you're getting to the collegiate level. Strength and growth, and that's all a really big factor of excelling in your sport.
You both are NCAA veterans in terms of being a big meet. Can you speak a little bit about what goes into being on a big stage?
I mean, just staying in the moment, I think, is the biggest thing, and not making too much of the meet. You know, the first time you go to NCAAs, it's a lot of stimulus, and you don't know what to do with the energy. There's a lot of energy there, and you don't really know how to necessarily control it or use it to your advantage. But being there multiple times, you kind of figure out how to use that energy to your advantage.
You definitely learn how to control your emotions a lot better. Your first time going there, you're competing against the nation's best, so you don't really know how to handle it. And it's kind of similar to going to any new championship. You know, you have the nervousness and you have a different type of emotions, but you learn how to control that very well.
How does that stage compare to Olympic CrossFit, or how will it
compare? You know, it's going to be totally different. You're still competing against the best in college, but then you move to competing to professionals and the best in the world, or even in the U.S. But, I mean, you are competing against people that will medal in the Olympic Games. So if you're up there in that top three spot, you are a contender to medal at the Olympics, and you are a great athlete and you're doing something right. It's a big change, but it's similar to in competition and emotion.
How difficult is it with the Olympic trials coming up to kind of put that out of your mind and stay focused on nationals?
I mean, personally for me, just focus, like I can't see past Thursday when I throw, so I just focus so hard just on the next competition, knowing you You can't really control, you know, trials is 4 weeks down the road. You can control, you know, what you do within the next week to prepare for NCAAs. So just really focusing up until your competition on that specific competition.
I agree with that. That's one thing I really tried to do this year is, you know, take things day by day, not really get too far ahead of yourself, because when you get too far ahead of yourself, it's kind of a distraction. So if you can just stay in the moment and work on things day by day, you find a lot better progress. I started when I was about in eighth grade. It's been in my family. My grandfather and my uncle both vaulted. My grandfather jumped when it was steel poles and sawdust, and he was through that era and taught my uncle how to vault. He got me into it in eighth grade or so. I didn't really like it at all, and I was kind of forced to do it. And then I got into it my freshman year of high school and actually jumped pretty well and started to really enjoy the sport, traveling with the team. And going all these places with a bunch of fantastic people and met a lot of great people. And then, you know, it grew on me and I started to really enjoy it. And I barely missed states that year and kind of fueled the fire a little bit, and then ended up jumping pretty well my sophomore year and found that I had a talent and a career for it.
Do